Hey guys, what's up? This is Mark, and I'm making this video to pretty much get over something. I've kind of talked about the new game that Remedy was making for the new Xbox One. But for right now, I'm going to pretty much talk about that some more and how I feel about, you know, them not making an Alan Wake 2. Now, if nobody really knows Remedy, they pretty much made Max Payne 1, 2, and Alan Wake, of course. Since Max Payne, I've been pretty much in love with Remedy. And, you know, when then Max Payne 2 came out, I was like super excited. I didn't really own the games. Whoever I hanged out with had them. But still, you know. Maybe at the time I didn't really know who Remedy was, but over time I started to, you know, focus on who made what. And then Alan Wake was announced. I didn't know about it around when it was actually announced, but right, pretty much right around 2008, that's when I heard about it, and I found out Remedy was making it, and I was like, this looks sweet, man! And, you know, I'm watching a trailer on my Xbox 360. I was just pretty much browsing through games, you know, the store, whatever. And there was Alan Wake, and I was, you know, checking it out, reading about it, you know, and there was a trailer, I watched it, and I was like, wow, this looks pretty damn good, you know? So I pretty much, you know, stayed in touch with it, and see how the development was going, and when it was released, I think it was 2009, I brought it home, pop it in, play it, and I'm like, oh my god, this is awesome! Oh, it's that amazing. Now I own all three of Remedy's games, you know. Max Payne for the Xbox, Max Payne 2 for the PlayStation 2. Sorry it looks like this. This is pretty much how it was when I got it. Apparently the person, didn't take care of the cover and just decided to do it like this. But yeah. And I got Alan Wake, that you've probably seen through my game collection videos. All three games equals pure brilliance. All three of them. And throughout, you know, ever since the first game, I was really hoping to get the second game, pretty much. You know, I heard there was like a bunch of rumors and all that, you know, saying it was being produced and all. But now, because, you know, with the whole live event of the new Xbox and Remedy coming out with a new IP, I was like so disappointed. I was like, you know, it's like I had that excitement, and then felt like I was just in an elevator going up. And then I'm going down, but it feels like I'm pretty much just stuck in a slow motion loop. Then I saw Sam Lake's video. He's the lead writer of Remedy. He writes the stories, and he also did the face of Max Payne 1. Nothing's too small. I'll put it in the video somewhere right here. Okay. yeah, he seemed like did the face of the first Max Payne. And, at the time, they were like, you know, very low, small, you know, game company, and they didn't really have that much staff back then, and they were pretty much like a basement company. They were that small. But over time, the crew, back to, Sam Lake, he made a video pretty much announcing, you know, that they're sorry that they weren't able to make Alan Wake 2, that they didn't really have the funding to do a sequel, which kind of made sense considering the fact that Alan Wake, the first Alan Wake, didn't really do that well in sales when it was first released. But over time it did, though, you know, pretty much like 3 million copies. It did do well, but not like when it was first launched. So, I don't know. I'm kind of confused pretty much. But I kind of do understand. I just, wish this wasn't real, you know, it was dreaming, but, yeah. But, they, you know, they're not saying that they're not going to do an Alan Wake 2. They did kind of do a teaser at the end. There was, like, a little teaser, like, kind of like an Indiana Jones parody where they locked up everything of Alan Wake in a box and a crate. And on the bottom it said, don't release until, you know, there's supposed to be some sort of year there, but it's like covered with a shadow. And then, yeah. You know, I'm not gonna give up hope. You know, I'm gonna keep rooting Remedy, you know, and try to, you know, see what comes. And as for Quantum Break, I don't know. I mean, I'm not excited for Xbox One. Xbox One, I can't really get over that. Stupid name, but anyways, maybe over time, you know, just when it's, you know, Xbox One is released and everyone pretty much has it, you know, and see where it goes from there, and maybe I'll get it, you know, if, you know, because obviously, you know, whatever Remedy releases, you know, it's gonna be awesome, and this new game, you know, probably is gonna be very awesome, very exquisite. So, probably over time, if I'm up to it, I'll get the Xbox One and pick up the new Remedy game, Quantum Break. But, you know, that's pretty much it for now. If Quantum Break, you know, does pretty much a good job, maybe they'll have enough funding for Alan Wake 2. And that's probably pretty much it, you know. They to get, like, a new thing going, you know, they decide, you know, let's just make an IP, try to get that, you know, success, and that way we can pretty much funding for and Alan Wake 2. So that's pretty much probably, you know, what's happening. And I'm hoping that's it. if I had, like, a lot of money, I would probably do, like, a Kickstarter thing, but I don't. I don't know anything about Kickstarter, pretty much. But, I don't know. What do you guys think, you know, about the whole situation? Give your opinion. And, hope you have a good day or a good night. Peace out. Laters, and bye.